The problem is the moral high ground he's taking doesn't exist above him.
I have been fighting for 17 years. I am willing to throw it all away to say to my senior leaders, I demand accountability.
That's the type of Marine Corps officer you want and expect, right? But is that career suicide for this young Lieutenant Colonel? Let's take a look. Let's go.
It was a failure by, the Taliban operate with varying degrees of competence. Some of those guys are very scrupulously good. Some of them are not.
You're going to hear keywords all the time like ISIS-K, Haqqani, Taliban, all this stuff. It's all the same group of people cut from the same cloth. These are all warlords trying to take Kabul.
The thing we do is we share versions of this information with the Taliban so that they can actually do some searching out there for us, and we believe that some attacks have been thwarted by them. And then we also use the Taliban as a tool to protect us as much as possible. But we share a common purpose. As long as we've kept that common purpose aligned, they've been useful to work with. They've cut some of our security concerns down.
This is the deadliest day since August 6, 2011, when we lost 31 Americans on Extortion 17.
Well, you can get an understanding after listening to that general of why the lieutenant colonel is upset. Instead of just saying, hey, we made a huge blunder in Afghanistan on several fronts, and we'll get to those. But the general says, well, we made them, the Taliban, they're good, ultimately. You know, take responsibility. I know Jocko Willink put out a piece on this on Fox News.
Explain what went wrong, take ownership of what went wrong, and then come up with a plan on how to fix it. That's what he needs to do.
I've never seen the military just have no excuse beyond, we relied on the Taliban. And I'm not going to get into the weeds too much with who we're pulling out, why we're pulling them out. This has been a disaster, and things happen. I get it. But you need to take some responsibility. And when you see the lieutenant colonel, we'll get further into that, his frustration with leadership. Think about this, too. He's been in 17 years. So since 2004, as a young second lieutenant in the meat grinder, in the infantry, you know, this guy's cut his teeth in the infantry, in combat. He can speak to this issue. Let's get back to what the lieutenant colonel had to say.
My name is Lieutenant Colonel Stu Scheller, United States Marine Corps. I'm the current battalion commander for Advanced Infantry Training Battalion. I've been in the Marine Infantry for 17 years. Started my tour with Victor 1-8. It's the current unit that's doing perimeter security, dealing with the mess that's going on there.
So this is where you want an experienced officer, right? In Infantry Training Battalion, Advanced Infantry Training Battalion, he said. He's got the experience. He's been an infantry officer. He's not trying to move up later in his career. So exactly where you want a man like this. He's got an opinion for a reason.
Making it because I have a growing discontent and contempt for my perceived ineptitude at the foreign policy level. And I want to specifically ask some questions to some of my senior leaders.
John, 2 days before Kabul fell, you said from that podium, quote, the city is not right now in any imminent threat environment. How could you get that so wrong?
In the moment that I said it, Lucas, it was true.
Let's talk about that. So foreign policy, military doesn't control that. They have input, right? But you think, and he gets to that, they would stand their ground and say, this is a bad idea, relying on the Taliban for security. Now, they're mixing and matching terms, ISIS-K, you know, you can call it whatever you want. But they're people who don't like us, right? Groups fighting, tribes fighting, but ultimately they don't want the U.S. there. I'm going to put words in his mouth, but how can we be that stupid to rely on the Taliban for any kind of security at this stage in the game? And then when there is a mistake, right, when there is a problem and people die and the general comes on and says, well, the Taliban are good and bad and makes all these excuses.
It was a failure by, the Taliban operate with varying degrees of competence. Some of those guys are very scrupulously good. Some of them are not.
You can understand the frustration.
And I'll say, as a person that's not at 20 years, I feel like I have a lot to lose. If you play chess, you can only see 2 to 3 moves out because there's too many variables. I thought through if I post this video, what might happen to me, especially if the video picks up traction, if I have the courage to post it.
Well, the video picked up traction. I think the guy should be promoted, quite frankly. We know that's not going to happen. What's the best thing for this man to do? Now, everybody in the comments, I posted this in a short video on JT Extra, said, Great guy. He stood up for the cause. The problem is, a year from now, no one will remember his name. If he's still in the Marine Corps, they let him go to 20. I doubt it. He got relieved of his command, which means he's effectively career suicide. So if he makes it to 20, that would be great. But if he doesn't, he's sunk. He doesn't get the pension, right? Now, you could say he could be a Fox News contributor. So that's his anguish here. What is this going to do to my 20 years I'm trying to get? I'm on year 17. I've put the time in, the heavy lifting. I don't know what I would do if it was a friend of mine, my brother. I'd say, get your 20, move on. That may be the coward's way to go, right? I don't know what this is going to do to him long term, and I don't know it's going to change anything. I hope it does.
What you believe in can only be defined by what you're willing to risk. So if I'm willing to risk my current battalion commander seat, my retirement, my family stability to say some of the things that I want to say, I think it gives me some moral high ground to demand the same honesty, integrity, accountability from my senior leaders.
I mean, what he's saying is true. He is taking the moral high ground. He's got something at risk. He's got skin in the game. 100% agree. The problem is the moral high ground he's taking doesn't exist above him, or we wouldn't be to this point. And that's the sad part about this for him, is I think the moral high ground is long gone, at least in the current group of leaders we've got. Now, there could be people who disagreed the decision, kept their mouth shut. So I'm not blaming everybody, but the ultimate leaders who are delivering the message to us, that Marine general who said, well, it's the Taliban's.
The Taliban operate with varying degrees of competence.
This or that, and they're good. Instead of saying, we made a big mistake. People died here. It shouldn't have happened. We're trying to leave the country. We don't give up Bagram Airfield to people who we were just fighting.
Current fallout of Afghanistan, a lot of Marines were posting on social media, and in response to that, the Commandant published a letter, which is the service chief of the Marine Corps, and I'm going to read from it. It was dated 18 August, so only a week ago. The Commandant, sir, you wrote, some of you may be struggling with the simple question, was it all worth it? We want you to know that your service is meaningful, powerful, and important. You fought for the Marine to your left and the Marine to your right. You never let them down.
That's not good enough from the Commandant. What's happening is not good enough. And what's my experience here? I grew up around a lot of Vietnam vets. I spent weekends at a VA hospital because my Marine uncle was injured with a brain injury. I saw these guys just saying a letter, you worked hard. The anguish guys like this, and I wasn't in Afghanistan, I can't speak to it, but growing up around Vietnam vets who felt what I perceive these guys to be feeling now is going to be a long road to hoe for them. You guys put in the comments, how does it make you feel? Does it make any difference in the end if we leave? Probably not, but the manner in which we did it and then sacrificing, at this point I guess it was 13 men and women for something we could have avoided if we had some leadership.
But the reason people are so upset on social media right now is not because the Marine on the battlefield let someone down. That service member has always rose to the occasion and done extraordinary things. People are upset because their senior leaders let them down, and none of them are raising their hands and accepting accountability or saying, we messed this up. If an 05 battalion commander has the simplest live fire incident EO complaint, boom, fired. But we have a Secretary of Defense that testified to Congress in May that the Afghan National Security Force could withstand the Taliban advance. We have chairmen of Joint Chief, who the Commandant is a member of that, who's supposed to advise on military policy. We have a Marine.
And you saw that across the board, administration, Secretary of Defense.
Things dramatically changed. I readily admit that. Things moved very, very quickly, Lucas.
No one's come out and said publicly, this is a bad idea. Now, after the fact, right? Maybe they thought it was going to work and they could slide through. After the fact, you think we say, we made a mistake, a grave mistake, and we take responsibility for it. Here's what we're doing to fix it. As of the recording of this video, I've heard none of that.
Combatant commander, all of these people are supposed to advise, and I'm not saying we've got to be in Afghanistan forever, but I am saying, did any of you throw your rank on the table and say, hey, it's a bad idea to evacuate Bagram Airfield, the strategic air barriers, before we evacuate everyone? Did anyone do that? And when you didn't think to do that, did anyone raise their hand and say, we completely messed this up? I've got battalion commander friends right now that are posting similar things, and they're saying, wondering if all the lives were lost and if it was in vain, all those people that we've lost over the last 20 years.
Well, if there were generals that said that, we're not hearing about it. And I understand it's career suicide. But you would hope, historically, you make decisions. And the Marine Corps has been pretty good about not going along to get along. But this is a new norm, I guess, where the Marine general comes out and says, oh, we trust the Taliban. And they could very well. But you take responsibility. Hey, some people are dead. Some young men and women died. And we made a mistake. And here's what we're doing to fix it. The delivery has just been the worst optics possible and the worst outcome possible.
And what I'll say is, and from my position, potentially all those people did die in vain if we don't have senior leaders that own up and raise their hand and say, we did not do this well in the end. Without that, we just keep repeating the same mistakes, this amalgamation of the economic slash corporate slash political slash higher military ranks are not holding up their end of the bargain.
Couple things he said. Political. Most generals are politicians, right? You don't make it that far without being a politician. And they're not holding up their end of the bargain. They want a CNN military advisor gig. They want to work as a lobbyist. I get it. Not all guys are bad guys. But when they get to that point, clearly the ones we have that are public facing now have taken the company line. Whether they wanted to or not, they took it. And they've got the ability to say something. They're already 20 plus years in their career. We saw what happened to McChrystal when he took a position against Obama about what we should do in the war. Seems like these guys have just gotten deballed somewhere along the line.
I want to say this very strongly. I have been fighting for 17 years. I am willing to throw it all away to...
What do you think is going to happen to this fine lieutenant colonel? We all probably think he should be promoted. How should he have handled it? I'm sure he addressed his concerns. And at this point, he's risking his 17 years and potentially his ability to get a pension. And when you leave the Marine Corps as a 17-year infantry officer, your skill set's not very transferable. Not to mention how you feel about your job, your responsibility. That's a hard transition to a full bird colonel who got out for 25 years. It's not easy. Let me know in the comments what you think will happen to this guy and what should happen to this guy. Thanks for watching.